First of all, thank you to every Democrat, Republican, and Independent from every corner of this state who came together today and gave us this overwhelming victory. Folks, this election was never about party. It was always about which candidate could best bring this Commonwealth together to tackle the challenges that we have. It was about who would make the tough decisions while protecting our most important priorities, the priorities of education, health care for our most vulnerable, public safety and job creation. It was about who remembered that at the end of the day, every decision we make affects real people in real ways. And that's something that I've never forgotten. When I stood here 4 years ago as your newly elected governor, I expressed the hope that we could put partisan divisions aside and come together to do some great things for Kentucky. And several times during the last 4 years, I've been able to get and bring our Republican Senate and our Democratic House together, and we've made progress. During the worst recession of our lifetimes, we have balanced our state budget 9 times, and we have protected education. We have reformed our pension and our unemployment insurance systems, and we've modernized our economic incentive toolbox so that we could create and retain jobs in every corner of the Commonwealth. But too often, rank partisanship has stood in the way of moving Kentucky forward. That's why, in this election, I ask the voters to send a strong message. A message rejecting the politics of obstruction, the politics of division, and the politics of religious intolerance. And today they have sent that message in the strongest possible terms. This overwhelming victory is a mandate for both parties to put partisanship aside and work together. It's a mandate to avoid the partisan gridlock that's engulfing Washington, D.C. right now and preventing this nation from meeting the most serious challenges that we have faced in generations. It is a mandate for compromise and for putting aside personal political agendas for the good of the Commonwealth. Tonight, Kentuckians sent an overwhelming message to every elected official that your first obligation is not to your political party, it's to the people of this state. I intentionally did not promise things in this campaign that I knew would be impossible to implement. Our economy is too fragile right now. But over the next 4 years, I intend to keep state government lean and efficient, even when economic conditions improve. Our conservative fiscal policies have allowed Kentucky to weather this recession better than most states, and we're going to continue those policies. In order for Kentucky to compete and to attract the jobs of today and tomorrow, I will fight for a world-class education system for every single Kentucky child. For every single Kentucky child, so that they have the tools they need to succeed in this 21st century. And my top priority as governor will continue to be creating a job for every Kentuckian who needs a job. There are still far too many people out of work and far too many families struggling to get by. Things are getting better, but still too slowly. Investment in Kentucky is on the rise, and I'm optimistic about our future. But no governor can do this alone. Over the next 4 years, I will continue to reach out to elected officials of any party to do what's best for the people of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. And I urge members of the General Assembly, Democrats and Republicans alike, to put party labels aside. Let's reject the political philosophy that says that you have to oppose an idea simply because your political opponent proposed it, or because your political leader tells you to. Folks, all of us must work together to create the Kentucky that we all know is possible. You know, there's a lot of folks to thank tonight, many of whom are right here in this room. First and foremost, Kentucky's First Lady, Jane Beshear, and my family. Next, Kentucky's next Lieutenant Governor, Jerry Abramson, and his partner, Madeline. Thank you goes to the rest of this great ticket of qualified individuals who will help me lead this Commonwealth through the next 4 years. Let's give them all a round of applause. Thank you to every volunteer who made phone calls, who knocked on doors, who put up yard signs. Thanks to the best campaign staff that a campaign has ever had in the Commonwealth of Kentucky, and to my campaign manager, Bill Hires. Thanks to the Kentucky Democratic Party and Chairman Dan Logsdon for their assistance in bringing this ticket home. My friends, thanks to the Republicans for Beshear, who put aside party labels to support our efforts to move our state forward. And most of all, thanks to the people of Kentucky. I'm proud of what we've accomplished these last 4 years under some very, very difficult circumstances. And I'm optimistic about our potential for the next 4 years. So to everyone in this room, enjoy this great victory tonight, because tomorrow we get back to work. Thank you all very much, and God bless each and every one of you.